Hi students, today we are going to learn about the mouth of a plant which is called stomata. Stomata. We have already learned about stomata in the lower classes, but in this class we are going to learn a little bit in detail. Stomata means mouth. Stomata means mouth. Now what is stomata? Stomata are tiny openings or pores that enable gaseous exchange. In the leaves, you know that in the plants there are leaves. These leaves, they breathe in carbon dioxide and they breathe out oxygen during the process of photosynthesis. So through the stomata, the leaves breathe in carbon dioxide and breathe out oxygen. That is what here it says, gaseous exchange. Now usually these stomatas are found on the lower surface of plant leaves, but they can also be found in some stems, because stems also takes part in photosynthesis. Some of the plant stems do photosynthesis. These plant stems are green in color, they also have the stomatas in them. Now you can see here structure of stomata. There are two stomatas here. One is opened stomata. This is opened stomata and this is closed stomata. You can see here some gap. This is opened stomata. And here it is closed. Okay, so there is no gap. Now here you can see, this is nucleus, and here these are chloroplast. These are all chloroplast. And here it shows the open stomata. Then this is epidermal cell. This is epidermal cell, and here the inner wall is thick cell wall. Okay. And this bean shape, this is guard cell. Okay. This is opened stomata. Each stomata has two bean shaped guard cells. They have inner thick walls as compared to the outer walls. When the guard cells are full of water, these guard cells fill with water, then it bulges outwards and then stomata opens. It bulges outwards. These guard cells fill with water and then it swell up and it bulged outwards. And the stomata opens. When the guard cells are filled with water, that is called turgid, then it bulges out and stomata get opens. And then when the guard cells lose water, they lose their turgidity and then the stomata close. These guard cells lose water and they lose the turgidity and then the stomata get closed. Let's see what are the functions of stomata. Number one, stomata helps in the exchange of gases between the leaves and the atmosphere. This stomata helps in exchange of gases. How? During daytime, the leaves prepare food for the entire plant. For that, the leaves need carbon dioxide. So through the stomata, the leaves breathe in carbon dioxide. And after the photosynthesis, the waste which is oxygen for the plant, that through the stomata it breathes out. That is what here gas exchange between the leaves and the atmosphere exists. Then the second point is it helps in the process of transpiration. What is transpiration? The removal of excess water from the plants in the form of water vapor through stomata is called transpiration. So this stomata helps in the process of transpiration. We have seen that the stomata get opens when the water is filled. The guard cells will bulge out, and because of that the stomata gets opened, and through the stomata the leaves will lose water, and that is called transpiration. It helps in the process of transpiration. Then once the water is lost, the stomata get closed. That is what it happens in the through the stomata. Stomatas are microscopic openings on the surface of plant leaves that allow for the easy passage of water vapors, carbon dioxide and oxygen. This is what is happening through the stomata. Once again, let's go through the topic, that is stomata. Stomata are the microscopic opening on the surface of plant leaves that allow for the easy passage of water vapors, carbon dioxide and oxygen. They are crucial to the function of leaves, as photosynthesis requires plenty of carbon dioxide as well as release of waste oxygen and excess of water vapor. Stomata means mouth. Through this stomata, this excess water will release through the stomata as water vapor. And not only that, during photosynthesis, this leaves need carbon dioxide that through stomata leaves breathe in. And after the photosynthesis, the waste product of plant, that is oxygen, through the stomata it breathes out. The number of stomata that are present in a plant depends on environmental conditions such as higher light levels and moisture or lower carbon dioxide level. The number of stomata that are present in the plant depends on the environment. Through the stomata, it needs to, during transpiration, it lose a lot of water. If these plants are in a desert place, then number of stomata are less. The plants will have less number of stomata because these plants, they don't want to lose much of water. That's the reason less number of stomata are present in the leaves in desert place. The main site of stomata is on leaf surface, but they are found on all above parts of the plant. Then their number increases in better environmental conditions to maximize the rate of photosynthesis. If the environment is better, then photosynthesis rate they want to increase, maximum rate of photosynthesis they want to do. So for that, they'll have more number of stomata present in the leaves. In warmer environments and particularly in dry air, plants lose a great amount of water through their stomata, and in such conditions stomata closes and rate of photosynthesis decreases. See, not only stomata get closed, because of stomata get closed, then gas exchange will be less, okay, gas exchange will reduce or decrease. Because of that, photosynthesis also decrease. This is done by plants to save their water reserves. Okay. They don't want to lose much of water, so they get the stomata get closed. Because of that, stomata get closed, the gas exchange also reduce, and when gas exchange reduce, photosynthesis rate will decrease. That is what exactly happens in the plants through the stomata. If you have any doubt regarding this topic, please mention that in the comment box so that I can explain to you again. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe. Press the bell icon to stay tuned.